अस्सलाम वालेकुम एवरीवन. सो टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट विद द चैप्टर नंबर 14 ऑफ बायोलॉजी स्टैंडर्ड 11th ह्यूमन न्यूट्रिशन पार्ट 3. सो टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट विद आवर नेक्स्ट टॉपिक ऑफ आवर सेम चैप्टर दैट इज डाइजेस्टिव ग्लैंड्स. डाइजेस्टिव ग्लैंड्स दे आर एसोसिएटेड विद द एलिमेंट्री कैनाल व्हिच इंक्लूड्स द सलाइवरी ग्लैंड्स, लिवर एंड पैंक्रियास. बेसिकली दीज ग्लैंड्स दे सिक्रीट द जूसेस. They secrete the digestive juices which helps in the digestion. Okay, therefore they are called as what? Digestive glands. So basically there are three different types of digestive glands. They are salivary glands, liver and pancreas. So now we are going to start with our first digestive gland, that is the salivary gland. Okay. We will see first the salivary gland. There are basically three pairs of the salivary glands. They are sublingual gland, submandibular gland and parotid gland. So there are basically three salivary glands. Sublingual, which is present below the tongue. Sublingual gland, they are present below the tongue. Whereas submandibular gland, they are present below the lower jaw, and the last one, that is the parotid gland, they are present in front of ear. Okay, now coming on the right side of the slide, that is what? Salivary glands, they are made up of two types of cells. They are serous cells and mucus cells. Serous cells secrete a fluid containing digestive enzyme. That digestive enzyme is called as salivary amylase and ptyalin. And these two enzymes, they have the consistency of watery fluid type of consistency. Okay, so what is that? Serous cells. Salivary glands are made up of two types of cells, serous cells and mucus cell. Now, this serous cell, they secrete a watery fluid, which contains the enzyme amylase and ptyalin. Coming to the mucus cell. Mucus cell produces mucus, which binds with the food and help in swallowing. Mucus cell, they produce the mucus which binds with the food and help in swallowing. So this is all about the salivary. Now the next gland is the liver. Liver is the largest gland. Okay, make it clear. Liver is the largest gland. Most of the time it is asked in general knowledge question also, that which is the largest gland. So the answer is the largest gland is the liver. Now first we will see the general points of the liver and then we will see the functions of the liver. So starting with the general points of the liver, it is the largest gland, as I have said earlier. Then the next point is, it is about 1.5 kg in weight, which is dark reddish brown in color. Human liver is about 1.5 kg in weight and it is about dark reddish brown in color, which is present just below the diaphragm. It is present on the right side below the diaphragm. The position is right side below the diaphragm. This is, I am saying, the position of the liver, right side below the diaphragm, whereas the weight is 1.5 kg. Weight of the liver is 1.5 kg and its color is reddish brown in color. Coming to the next point, bile juice secreted by liver, bile juice secreted by the liver cells, they stored in the gallbladder. Okay. So, liver secretes the bile juice, which helps in the digestion process. So, this bile juice, which is secreted by the liver cells, they are stored in the gallbladder. Now, the next one is, liver cells are called as hepatic cell. They are also called as hepatic cell. Next, I would like to say some more points on the liver, which is not mentioned in the slide. So they are of about each. They contain the two different types of lobe. Each lobe of this, they are bilobed gland, and it is covered by the thin covering called as Gleason's capsule. This capsule is made up of connective tissue. Each lobe is divided into several structure. They are bilobed and each lobe is divided into several structure. And functional unit of liver is called hepatic lobules. The functional unit of the liver is called as what? Hepatic lobules. Whereas its liver cells are called as what? Hepatic cells. Each hepatic lobule is polygonal in shape. At the junction of adjacent lobules, a triangular portal area is present. In this portal area, a branch of each of hepatic artery, hepatic portal vein, and bile duct is present. So this is all about the physical structure of the liver. A lobule consists of cords of hepatic cells which are arranged around a central vein. In between the cords of hepatic cells, spaces called sinusoids are present through which the blood flows. In sinusoids, the phagocytic cells called Kupffer cells are present. Phagocytic cells means they engulf all the waste material of the cell. So that is called as what? Phagocytic cell. So in the sinusoids, the phagocytic cells, they are called Kupffer cells, they are present. These cells, they destroy the toxic substances. The Kupffer cells, what is the function? The function is they destroy the toxic substances, dead and worn out blood cells and the microorganisms which are harmful to our body. Next is what? Hepatic cells produce bile juice. It is collected and carried through the bile duct and stored in the sac-like structure called as gallbladder. The duct of the gallbladder and hepatic duct together form common bile duct. Liver is a vital organ. Bile juice secreted by liver emulsifies the fat and makes the food alkaline. Now, coming to the right side, and we will discuss regarding its function. Bile emulsifies the fat and makes the food alkaline. Now, what do you mean by emulsifies or emulsification? Means converting the complex substances into the smaller particles, or you can say chopping of the substances into the smaller particles. So bile, what it do? The bile, it emulsifies the fat. It chops down the fat. It cuts down the fat and makes the food alkaline. When the food is basically acidic, its ratio is towards the acidic, then this bile, it emulsifies the fat. It chops down the fat. It cut down the fat and makes the food alkaline. Okay. Next point, liver stores the excess of glucose in the form of glycogen. Liver stores the excess of glucose in the form of glycogen. Excess of amino acid are converted to अमोनिया. When in our body excess of amino acids are present, then this excess of amino acids, they are harmful for our body. Therefore, it has to be get converted into ammonia, okay, by the process called as deamination. So, this process that is called deamination, it is also done by liver. If it is not done, then it will be very harmful for our body, okay. So, deamination is one of the important process which is done by liver. Coming to the next point, liver also synthesizes vitamin A, D, K and B12. It is also involved in the synthesis of vitamin A, D, K and B12. Then, what next? The function is, liver also produces blood proteins. Liver also produces the blood proteins like prothrombin, fibrinogen. All these are formed in the liver. So, liver, they produces different types of blood proteins like prothrombin and fibrinogen. Okay. Then it also produces the RBCs, red blood corpuscles. Liver also produces the RBCs, that is called red blood corpuscles, during the embryonic stage, during the child's developmental stage, that is called as what? The embryonic stage. Hence it is called hematopoietic cells. Therefore, as they are produced during the embryonic stage, therefore, they are called hematopoietic cells. Then coming to the last function, Kupffer cells also digest the old RBCs. This is the function of the Kupffer cells. Kupffer cells also digest the old RBCs or worn out RBCs, as it helps in the detoxification process. Kupffer cells helps in the detoxification process and destruction of old RBC. So, this is all about the liver, its physical structure or its general points, and on the right side, the function of the liver. Now, coming to our next topic, next digestive gland is pancreas. Pancreas is a leaf-shaped heterocrine gland. It is a leaf-shaped heterocrine gland which is present in the gap formed by bend of duodenum and under the stomach. Okay. So, pancreas, it is what? They are present between the duodenum and stomach. Basically, I just want to say that pancreas is one of the digestive gland which is present between the duodenum and the stomach. Duodenum, it is the last portion of the large intestine and which enters into the and which is present into the large intestine. And stomach, you all know very well. So, the position of the pancreas is what? Where does it situated? It is situated between the duodenum and the stomach. Coming to the next point, pancreas is called, it is a mixed gland. Mixed gland means some parts of the pancreas, they undergo as a exocrine gland, or you can say they work, some portion of the pancreas, it works as an endocrine gland, whereas some part of the pancreas, it works as an endocrine gland. Because of this feature, pancreas is called as what? They are mixed gland. Exocrine part of pancreas is made up of acini. Exocrine part of pancreas is made up of acini. Acini is the cell. Acinar cells secrete the alkaline pancreatic juice that contains the various digestive enzymes. The pancreatic juice is collected and carried to duodenum by pancreatic duct. I'm repeating it once more. Pancreatic juice is collected and carried to the duodenum by pancreatic duct. The common bile duct joins the pancreatic duct to form the hepatopancreatic duct. It opens into duodenum. Opening of the hepatopancreatic duct is guarded by sphincter of Oddi. It is guarded by sphincter of Oddi. Now we will see the endocrine part. Endocrine part of the pancreas is made up of a group of cells called islets of Langerhans. I am repeating it once more. Endocrine part of the pancreas is made up of group of cells called as islets of Langerhans, which is present between the acini. They are present between the acini. Islets of Langerhans. Islets contain the three types of cells: alpha cells, which secretes the glucagon; beta cells, which secretes the insulin; whereas somatostatin. This is also one type of the cell. So somatostatin hormone, and it is secreted by the gamma cells. So basically, islets contain the three type of cells: alpha cells, beta cells, and gamma cells. Alpha cells secrete the glucagon, whereas beta cells secrete the insulin, and delta cells secrete the glucagon hormone. Glucagon and insulin together control the blood sugar level. Glucagon and insulin together control the blood sugar level. Whereas when the glucagon and insulin are together, they control the blood sugar level. Whereas somatostatin hormone, it inhibits the glucagon and insulin secretion. Okay. So this is all about the pancreas. Thank you, y'all. So now, in the next lecture, I'm going to discuss all the remaining part of our chapter. Thank you so much.